ट्राइटॉमिक गैस। यस समृद्धि।
मैम 4/3।
4/3। एंड हाउ मेनी डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम?
सिक्स।
यस 6 डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम। एनी एग्जांपल? एनी एग्जांपल?
H2O।
H2O। यस इट्स नॉन लीनियर ट्राइटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल। यस ओके। एंड नोट डाउन वन थिंग मोर। If we have different moles of gas, then Cp and Cv can be written as N1 Cp1 plus N2 Cp2. Means if different gases, there is a mixture of different gases, then we can write like this. We can find effective Cp and Cv like this. If we are having a mixture of gases, these many moles of one gas are given, these many moles of another gas are given, then we can find Cp and Cv first, and then by dividing we can find gamma. All right. Okay, so next after that is mean free path. After this, next is mean free path. Who will define mean free path? When we were doing postulates of kinetic theory of gases, we defined it. Mean free path. Kaun batayega? Yes, students, what is mean free path? Hurry up. Come on. Yes. Anyone? Mean free path? Yes, Samriddhi. और कोई? श्रेया। यस श्रेया। श्रेया आप बताओ।
मैम डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय अ मॉलिक्यूल बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव कोलिजन इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन।
यस वेरी गुड। This is a straight line path. Otherwise, I told you the gas molecules are in random motions. But if we see between two successive collisions, the path traveled by a gas molecule is straight line path. And this path is called mean free path. So distance traveled by a molecule between two successive collisions, that is called mean free path. Okay, so let us derive an expression for this. After defining it, so let us say the gas is enclosed in a cylindrical container. Okay, let us say the gas is enclosed in a cylindrical container of length L. Okay, there are some gas molecules here. These are some gas molecules and diameter is small d, suppose. Diameter. So this much is small d. Okay. For simplicity, let us first of all take only one molecule in motion. This molecule in motion. Let us assume that other molecules are at rest. This and this are at rest for the timing. For having simplicity in calculations, let us assume only one gas molecule in motion right now. So what is N? N is number density, number of molecules per unit volume. Number of molecules per unit volume. Volume of what? Volume of container. And this container is cylinder. So volume of cylinder it will be. Okay. So how many molecules are contained? How many molecules are there in the container? Let's cross multiply N into volume of cylinder. How much is the volume of cylinder? Pi D square L. Because the you can see radius of the cylinder is equal to diameter of the molecule. So This is pi d square l. Radius of the cylinder is d, small d. So we have found number of molecules contained in the container, cylindrical container. Now when observe this molecule, when it will move through the length of container, it will go from one side to the other side. It will cover the whole length of the cylinder. It will go on colliding with other gas molecules. How many collisions it will suffer? How many collisions it will suffer? Equal to number of molecules. Jitne molecules hain unke saath ye collide karega. We suppose we have already assumed ki baki molecules abhi rest pe hain. Theek hai? So let us find mean free path, which is distance, nothing but distance. So distance we can write mean, average distance. Theek hai? So average kaise nikalte hain hum? Total distance over total number of molecules. Average aise hi nikalte hain na, total distance over total number. Number of what? Number of molecules. So this distance is total distance traveled by the molecule, which is equal to length of the cylinder, over total number of molecules that we have found. That is equal to number of molecules. As many molecules are there, as many collisions will be there. So have a look at all the steps first. If anything is not clear, you can ask. First, we found the number of molecules. Then, simply we have applied the formula of mean distance. Okay, simply we have used this formula of mean distance. That is sum, total sum over number. This is how we calculate the mean or average. So, same thing we have done. And total distance is equal to L, length of the container. L gets cancelled and we get lambda is equal to 1 by pi n d square. We learn in this form, and to be very precise, under root pi n d square. Now what is the reason why I have introduced additional factor of root 2 here? This is the factor. Other, if we could have taken all the molecules in motion, this is not possible that what we have assumed that only one molecule is in motion, others are at rest. This is not possible. Actually, all the molecules are in motion. And if we take all molecules in motion, then this factor of under root 2 will be there. And we had just to avoid complexity, we have done the simple thing. तो आगे अंडर रूट का फैक्टर लगा दीजिए, अंडर रूट टू का रीजन दे दो, बिकॉज ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर इन मोशन, सो देयर इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ एडिशनल फैक्टर ऑफ अंडर रूट टू आल्सो. लर्न दिस फॉर्मुला, वी कैन डायरेक्टली अप्लाई इन न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स. सो दिस इज द डेरिवेशन ऑफ मीन फ्री पाथ. इज दैट क्लियर? सो आवर काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेज इज ओवर नाउ. ओके, सो दिस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर यूनिट इज ओवर. Tomorrow you keep your NCRT with you and we will do its exercise. Baki bulk matter ki humne kar li thi exercise. Theek hai, liquids wagaira ki humne exercise kar li thi. Gases ki exercise kal hum karenge, aap book leke baithna. NCRT, right? So any doubt from this chapter, you can ask first. Then we will start with thermal properties of matter. Or we will start with heat and thermodynamics. Yes, Divanshi. हाँ बोलो दिवांशी.
मैम एक बार जो आपने दो फॉर्मूलास बताए थे ना स्टार्टिंग में सीपी और सीवी के, वे बार दोबारा बता दो.
सीपी और सीवी के फॉर्मूला? फॉर्मूला तो कोई नहीं बताया बच्चे, मैंने सिर्फ यही बताया था गामा सीपी बाय सीवी होता है. सीपी और सीवी की मैंने डेफिनेशन बताई थी आपको, आई थिंक उसको अब हम डिटेल में करेंगे ना अभी थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर में. यस
मैम, जो भी आपने स्टार्टिंग में मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस का बताया था ना सीपी और सीवी, वो पूछ रही हूं.
ओके ओके. हाँ ये देखो, like we have calculated CP and CV for different gases. अगर mixture of gases हो तो ऐसे हम निकाल सकते हैं where n, n1, n2 are number of moles of those gases. ठीक है, अभी इसकी जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी आपको. थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर में हमने करना ही है दोबारा से. ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट यूनिट, हीट एंड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर और हीट पार्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू डू द हीट पार्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल what is heat, what is temperature, what is thermometer, you already are aware of all these things. What is heat? Heat is a form of energy that gives us sensation of warmth, and this is on account of collisions among the molecules of a substance. Why the substance gets heated up? Because the molecules of that substance, they are constantly colliding with each other, and due to these collisions what happens? The temperature of the gas rises, temperature of the substance rises, and it gets heated up. It acquires heat energy. Okay, so write the definition of heat. Heat is a form of energy that gives us sensation of warmth. And any substance has heat energy on account of collisions among its molecules. Okay, collisions among the molecules of substance increase its temperature. Since heat is also a form of energy, its unit is also joule. Heat is a form of energy, its unit is also joule. Earlier its unit used to be calorie. Heat energy ka aisa unit pehle calorie hua karta tha, theek hai, but ab nahi hai kyunki aapko pata hai ki rationalize ho gaya, system of units has been rationalized now. Right, so all the forms of energy have the same unit joule. All right, आपको पता है कि heat को पहले energy से पहले it was supposed to be a liquid. Okay, there was a scientist Benjamin Franklin. He wanted to prove that heat is a liquid. So what did he do? He continued boring in a cannon for 2 days continuously. तो उसने वो जो मशीन होती है उससे बोरिंग करनी स्टार्ट की. उसने कहा कि अगर ये हीट लिक्विड है तो वन डे इट विल स्टॉप कमिंग आउट. मैं मतलब 2 डेज में सारी की सारी हीट बाहर निकाल दूंगा, सारी की सारी हीट बाहर निकाल दूंगा. सो अर्लियर इट वाज सपोज दैट हीट इज अ लिक्विड. सो ही कंटिन्यूड बोरिंग इन अ कैनन फॉर 2 डेज कंटिन्यूसली, बट इट कंटिन्यूड टू कम आउट, इट डिड नॉट स्टॉप कमिंग आउट. So that means heat is a form of energy. It's not a liquid that will vanish out, that will come out completely, right? So this way it was proved that heat is not a liquid. Otherwise, by the nature of heat, that it flows from hotter object to colder object, it was supposed to be a liquid earlier. But later on, it was proved through the experiment of Benjamin Franklin, and later on through the work of Joule, scientist Joule. It was proved that heat is a form of energy. Rather, it is related to conversion of energy. Sometimes work is converted into heat, and sometimes heat energy is converted into mechanical energy. So this way they related. All right. So next term is temperature. Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a substance. You know that heat temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a substance. And earlier there used to be degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit. There were the units for temperature, but now Kelvin has been accepted as the SI unit of temperature. And we also covered it in our first unit among the fundamental units, right? Kelvin was our fundamental unit. Out of 7 fundamental quantities, temperature is also one of the quantities. What is the relation between Celsius and Fahrenheit? You know, the device used to measure temperature is called thermometer. We all know that. And the first thermometer was air thermometer, gas thermometer, based on the principle that gases expand on heating. Okay, but later on, mercury was used in the thermometers. What are the advantages of mercury for its use as a thermometric liquid? First thing is that since the tube of thermometer is glass tube, mercury does not stick to the glass. कोई और liquid लेते तो वो stick कर जाता, ठीक है, तो उतना clean rise नहीं होता उसमें. And second thing is its coefficient of thermal expansion is very large. So for small change in temperature of the body, there is a large expansion in level of mercury in the thermometer. So by that increase, we come to know whether the object is having a rise in temperature or fall in temperature, right? For example, when we use clinical thermometer, when we are having fever, whenever our temperature exceeds the normal body temperature, then we easily read it through mercury thermometer. The level of mercury becomes high in the thermometer, it expands very efficiently, and we are able to read the temperature of our body, right? So this is the second main advantage why mercury is used as a thermometric liquid. Okay, like we did in properties of matter, why mercury is used as a barometric liquid. So uski kya reasons the, chalo batao, kaun batayega? Why is mercury used as a barometric liquid? Aapko properties of matter se kya pata chala? Ki kyun hum use karte hain mercury ko barometer? Yes, anyone? Raise hand. Yes. Why is mercury used as a barometric liquid? इसको हमने बहुत अच्छे से डिटेल में एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ है, हमने दूसरे लिक्विड्स का भी एक्सप्लेन किया हुआ है कि उनको क्यों नहीं यूज करते. सो व्हाई डू वी यूज मर्करी एज अ बैरोमेट्रिक लिक्विड? एनीवन, रेज हैंड. यस दिवांशी
मैम, बिकॉज़ इट डज नॉट गेट स्टिक टू द ग्लास एंड इट्स डेंसिटी इज वेरी हाई.
डेंसिटी हाई होने से क्या होता है? सेकेंड रीजन क्या है? एक तो ये स्टिक नहीं होता, दैट इज वेरी गुड. सेकेंड रीजन ये नहीं है. सेकेंड रीजन हाँ रिलेटेड है, बट द मेन थिंग इज, यस समृद्धि आप बताओ.
मैम मर्करी की हाइट जो बैरोमीटर के लिए बिल्कुल सही है.
द हाइट ऑफ मर्करी बैरोमीटर इज फिजिबल. It is 76 centimeter of mercury column. One atmospheric pressure equivalent to that. So 1 meter length of barometer would be sufficient. That we are using in lab. Okay. If you see other liquids, then the length of barometer becomes impractically high. Length is very very large. That is practically not possible to handle. Like for water barometer, the height should be 10 meter approximately, which is not feasible to have. Okay, so this was the main reason why mercury is used as a barometric liquid. So now we are talking about why mercury is used as a thermometric liquid. One reason is the same, it doesn't stick to the glass. Second reason is its thermal coefficient of thermal expansion is very high. Okay, for small change in temperature, it expands efficiently. Other liquids don't expand so much for very low value of temperature. Okay, they don't expand for very low value of temperature. That is the reason. Okay. Now, suppose we have, you know the structure of a thermometer already. ठीक है, lower classes में आप बनाते भी थे. ये एक thermometer है. ठीक है, तो देर इज अ ग्लास बल्ब एट द बॉटम एंड देर आर सम कैलिब्रेशंस. किंक भी है कि बैक फ्लो ना हो मर्करी का, ठीक है, ये सब आपको पता है. एंड रेंज ऑफ मर्करी, रेंज ऑफ लैब थर्मोमीटर, क्लिनिकल थर्मोमीटर, वो आप सब करते थे, उसमें पढ़ते थे, है ना. तो डिग्री सेल्सियस, अगर हम सेल्सियस थर्मोमीटर लेते हैं तो लोएस्ट टेम्परेचर इज 0 degree Celsius एंड हाईएस्ट टेम्परेचर इज 100 degree Celsius. लोएस्ट टेम्परेचर, लोअर फिक्स पॉइंट, दैट इज टेकन टू बी द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर, एंड अपर फिक्स पॉइंट, दैट इज टेकन टू बी द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर. And in degree Celsius, we already know that water freezes into ice at 0 degree Celsius and it boils at 100 degree Celsius. In Fahrenheit, the lower fixed point is found at 32 degree Fahrenheit and upper fixed point is found at 212 degree Fahrenheit. ठीक है, ये भी आपने लोअर क्लासेस में पढ़ा हुआ है आई थिंक. The difference between upper fixed point and lower fixed point is called fundamental interval. The difference between lower and upper fixed points is called fundamental interval. So in case of Celsius thermometer, it is 100 degree Celsius minus 0 degree Celsius. That is 100. So fundamental interval in Celsius thermometer is 100. How much is fundamental interval in Fahrenheit temperature? Yes. Fahrenheit thermometer pe kya hai? Fahrenheit scale pe what is the fundamental interval? Yes. Who will tell me? What is the fundamental interval on a Fahrenheit scale? Yes, students, hurry up. Very simple, 212 upper fixed point minus lower fixed point, 180. So that proves that the fundamental interval in case of Fahrenheit thermometer is more than that in case of Celsius thermometer. Usme zyada hai. Iska matlab uski ek division kam hogi. Fahrenheit thermometer ki ek division smaller hogi as compared to that of Celsius or centigrade thermometer. Aur Kelvin. Kelvin scale pe yahi temperature jo hai, lower fixed point is at 273 Kelvin. To be very precise, it is 273.15, ठीक है? And upper fixed point is at 373 Kelvin. Approximately, we round it off and we write 273 and 373 Kelvin. So, how much is fundamental interval in that case? 373 minus 273, again 100. That means the one division in Celsius scale is equivalent to one division on Kelvin scale. To find the relationship between these temperature scales, we have a general formula. What is that? Unknown temperature minus lower fixed point over fundamental interval. This is the way of writing temperature on any thermometric scale. So let us apply it for Celsius and Fahrenheit first. Unknown temperature on Celsius scale is C, suppose we denote it by symbol C. Lower fixed point is 0. Fundamental interval is 100. Equal to. On Fahrenheit scale, unknown temperature is F. Lower fixed point is 32. Fundamental interval is 180. Okay, this way we can find relation between any two thermometric scales. So this is C over 100, F minus 32 over 180. Cancel it out. Take this 5 on that side. 5 by 9, F minus 32. So this was the relation that you used to cram in the lower classes. C is equal to 5 by 9 F minus 32. Yehi formula cram karte the na. So this is the proof of the formula. So Celsius thermometer can be converted into Fahrenheit and Fahrenheit can be converted into Celsius using this relation. Okay. So write one question. At what temperature do the Celsius and Fahrenheit scales coincide? कौन सा टेम्परेचर है जो सेल्सियस और फेरनहाइट पे सेम है? कौन सा टेम्परेचर है जो सेल्सियस और फेरनहाइट पे सेम है? लिखो क्वेश्चन. At what temperature do the Celsius and Fahrenheit scales coincide? At what temperature do the Celsius and Fahrenheit scales coincide? So according to the question, put C is equal to F equal to X here and find X. Yes, do it. Do it just now. And tell me what is answer. मतलब अदरवाइज वी हैव सीन कि उस पे 100 है फंडामेंटल नंबर ऑफ डिवीजन इज 100, उस पे 180 है, बट फिर भी एक टेम्परेचर है जो दोनों में कॉमन. यस रेज हैंड, हु नोज द आंसर? नहीं हुआ सॉल्व? यस अर्शदीप.
मैम एक्स इज इक्वल टू 40.
माइनस 40 नहीं आ रहा, माइनस 40 आएगा. माइनस 40 डिग्री सेल्सियस इज इक्वल टू माइनस 40 डिग्री फारेनहाइट. तो रिमेम्बर ये वाला टेम्परेचर सेम आता है, ठीक है? सो दैट इज माइनस 40 डिग्री सेल्सियस और माइनस 40 डिग्री फारेनहाइट. हाँ जी पुलकित. और अब इसी से आप ये भी फाइंड कर सकते हो कि नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर कितना है, 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस सेल्सियस में. अब इसको यहाँ पे पुट करो क्योंकि समटाइम्स देयर इज अ कंफ्यूजन कि नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर इन फारेनहाइट 98.6 है कि 98.4 है. तो अब आप इसमें पुट करके एक्चुअली चेक कर सकते हो. सो पुट नॉट हियर, हियर सेल्सियस को यहाँ पे 37 पुट करके फारेनहाइट टेम्परेचर यहाँ पे आप वेरीफाई करिए. तो करिए कितना आता है, 98.6 आता है कि 98.4 आता है? यू कैन एक्चुअली वेरीफाई नाउ. ओके फाइन. क्लियर? कितना आ रहा है, 98.6 आएगा. सो नॉर्मल बॉडी टेम्परेचर इन फारेनहाइट इज 98.6 एंड इन सेल्सियस इट इज एग्जैक्टली 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस. अब फाइंड करते हैं रिलेशन बिटवीन सेल्सियस एंड केल्विन, वही यही वाला फॉर्मूला यूज करके, दिस वन. सो सी माइनस 0 ओवर 100. अब केल्विन के लिए अननोन टेम्परेचर इज के माइनस लोअर फिक्स पॉइंट इज 273, फंडामेंटल इंटरवल इज अगेन 100. फंडामेंटल इंटरवल कितना है, 100 ही है. तो ये कैंसल आउट हो गया, तो सी आ गया आपका के माइनस 273. सो केल्विन स्केल कैन बी फाउंड from the Celsius scale by adding 273. Exactly it is 273.15. So this is the relation between Celsius and Kelvin. अब आप बड़े हो गए हो तो exact learn करो 273.15. So Kelvin scale is equal to Celsius plus 273.15 and you can have an idea from here also. ये Celsius में था 0 degree Celsius, है ना? Celsius में ये था 0 degree Celsius. और प्लस 273 किया तो केल्विन में 273 हमने लिखा हुआ है लोअर फिक्स पॉइंट को. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन केल्विन एंड सेल्सियस स्केल्स. तो आप देखोगे एक्सरसाइज का जो फर्स्ट ही क्वेश्चन है उसमें उन्होंने यही कहा हुआ है कि इसके बॉइलिंग पॉइंट को, इसके फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट को उसमें कन्वर्ट करो, उसमें कन्वर्ट करो. सो यू कैन यूज दीज टू रिलेशन, दिस एंड दिस. ओके फाइन स्टूडेंट्स, क्लियर है ये आपको? ठीक है, हैव अ लुक एट दिस. एनी डाउट इफ यू हैव यू कैन आस्क. कोई डाउट है आपका पूछ सकते हो. नहीं है कोई डाउट?